What is up, home workout and bodyweight exercise fans? In today's video for Made Muscle, we'll be talking about the importance of having a pre-scheduled weekly eating plan. This is essential for people who live on their own, bachelors, or even if you live with other people and you just want to do your own thing. If you're really busy, you know, if you're on a tight schedule, if you're working and you have really little few time to prepare your meals, this is the best way you can assure yourself that you'll be eating healthy and, you know, you won't be wasting a lot of time. In summary, the reason why you need this plan is because when you're really busy, when you're depleted, you know, drained, emotionally charged, and you have to make a nutritional decision, you know, the more you are like this in combination with being unorganized, like having no clue what you can eat or what you should eat on that day, the more all of that stuff you are, the more stupid your nutritional choices will be. And that happens to all of us, you know, even with me. If I have like no plan on what to eat today and I'm really tired and busy, I'm kind of drained, you know, and I haven't slept well, I won't make a smart nutritional choice. Why? Because in those states, you just tap into your primal brain, and what your primal brain is only interested in is the fattiest, saltiest, sweetest, and in general, the most caloric dense food it can get its hands on. The only thing that can help you make the right choice when you're at that state is having a really clear and actionable meal list. Now, a proper pre-scheduled weekly eating plan should include three basic lists, which are these. Number one, your weekly main meal list. So these are all the main meals you cook once per day. Now, how should these look more or less? Well, they should be, first of all, healthy and have a little bit of everything, carbs, macronutrients, and protein. They should be ideally home cooked. If you can't do that, you know, if that's not an option for you and you can just order, make sure that the quality of the food and the place that you order this food is quite good. You know, you want something healthy. It has to be warm. So this is basically the meal of the day that you sort of reward yourself. You know, it has to be both healthy and tasty. You know, it shouldn't be too boring. And it has to be eaten during a time of the day that you can eat in a relaxed state and have a few minutes later on to also digest this. Ideally, you should be having this late after your work when you can go home and kick back. So for most people, that's like 6 in the afternoon or 7 p.m. That's when I have my main meal of the day. And moving on, our second basic list is your daily snacks. These are basically all the meals that surround your main meal of the day. They can be snacks, you know, small, like little meals, or they can just be like just medium towards light meals. How many should they be? It depends on your lifestyle, on how much time you have, and, you know, on your goals. So caloric wise, protein wise, they should be providing sufficient of the a sufficient amount of those things. And they have to be, these are more consistent, you know, like in the main meal of the day, you need variability. You don't want to be eating the same things every day. But with these, the daily snacks, you want more consistency and efficiency. You know, for me, they're basically the same every day, and that's what I recommend to most people. Like, have maybe a few alternatives for some of these meals, but make sure they are more consistent, you know, so that way every day this becomes more of an automatic process, the preparation of these foods. You can maybe even prepare them in batches. You know, you want them to be simple, fast, and just have the right nutrition in them. I'm going to be showing you examples of all of these soon. Moving on, the third list that you need is your weekly shopping list. So what you do with this is basically you want to make sure that you have all the ingredients required to prepare the meals in the previous two lists. I'll be talking also about this in more detail soon. So this is the main meal weekly list. I write these down in index cards. Index cards are quite handy. I like them because, you know, they're a little bit of more rough paper. It's always good to have these on your fridge. I don't like having these in like digital formats in my phone, because, you know, they feel more clear. You can also memorize them better when you see them on paper, and it's good to have them on your fridge in general. You can also have a copy on your phone as well, for more flexible reasons. And as you can see in this list, on Mondays I start with baked potatoes and veggies. Basically, this is like a baked ratatouille, and I also combine this with a source of protein. So usually this will be Skyr Icelandic yogurt. That's like a really high protein yogurt, really awesome. Check it out if you don't know it. And, you know, I make sure I get enough of carbs, enough protein. I cook these with like zucchini, eggplant, tomatoes, so, you know, you also get all the veggies you need. Moving on, Tuesday I have steak, potatoes and salad. And what I do here is on Monday, when I cook my, you know, when I bake my potatoes, I bake a big batch. This way I can put some of those in a tupper, put that tupper in the fridge and reheat it the next day. So the next day I just have to cook my steak, prepare some veggies, you know, and that's also more practical because I don't have to peel off potatoes again or cook rice and stuff like that. It's, you know, due to efficiency reasons, you'll see that the order of the foods in my plan also have, you know, a reason. They're not just randomly ordered. So moving on, Wednesday, I'll have beans and rice. Excellent combination for getting a lot of protein, because combining beans and rice gives you a complete profile of amino acids that is basically equal to meat. So, you know, you're getting really, really good quality of protein there. And I combine that with fried veggies. So I basically fry my veggies on a pan with some teriyaki sauce, and I throw the beans and the rice, I stir them a little bit with all the veggies, and I have that. I'll include a photo from my Instagram account so you can check out how that looks. And I'll usually combine this with another 100 grams of cottage cheese just to round up my protein numbers. Moving on, Thursday, I'll have fish, fried veggies and cruciferous veggies. Those are basically the veggies most people don't like, so things such as broccoli, cauliflower and all that. And I combine that with some leftover rice and beans from the previous day. So that's how I get my carbs. Just a little bit of that. I focus more on getting a lot of protein this day with my fish. And what I do on Wednesdays is, you know, when I cut my veggies, so I cut some paprika, some mushrooms, and stuff like that. I also chop enough of those and put them in a tupper so I can use them again on Thursday with my fish. So, you know, that way I don't have to chop again vegetables the next day. So these are like little tweaks you can always make in order to save time. Moving on, Friday I'll have usually grilled chicken with some veggies like a salad, a fresh salad, and some carbs. Things such as rice or Greek pita. A lot of times this can be takeaway. So Fridays I usually work till late, and, you know, it's practical for me to order because I won't usually have time to cook. What I'll do is maybe also have like a Greek gyros with souvlaki, chicken souvlaki. And, you know, that's how I roll on Fridays. Saturday I'll either cook with friends or I'll have Chinese food. The choice I make there is fried rice with fried vegetables and tofu. So, you know, I get my veggies, my protein, my carbs and all that. Saturday is chill out day. So, you know, it's kind of like a cheat day. And I have like a big ass dessert after that. And I'll also have some drinks. So usually the rest of the week I won't drink any alcohol. So on Saturdays I'll just take an easy day, you know, chill out with my friends, have like about 3 to 4 beers or something like that. I don't go to extremes with alcohol. I don't like how I feel after that. And the next day, and Sunday is leftover day. If you're a guy, a bachelor living on your own, you'll notice that so many times you're left with, you know, old food that goes bad and you just have to throw it. So every Sunday what I do is I just gather all my leftovers and make like a creative combination in some way, such as this omelet you can see here in this pic. So this omelet has bacon, eggs, some leftover beans, some spinach, some tomato. What else? Yeah, I think that's all it had, but it tastes pretty awesome. A little bit of brown bread, of whole wheat bread, a little bit of cottage cheese, and there you go, you have like a really awesome, nutritious meal. Now, this was our main meal weekly list, and moving on, we'll be reviewing our daily snack list. So once again, these are like the all the rest of the meals that surround the main meal of the day. Here's an example of what I eat over here. I have four light meals slash snacks, although, you know, this doesn't mean that I sit in the kitchen every time I have to eat. For example, I start my day at around 5:30 in the morning. I'll have just a black coffee, then at around 10 o'clock I'll have my first meal, and that's gonna be a shake, a protein shake, where I include a handful of berries, mixed berries. I just take these frozen and, you know, put them in the shaker. They also make the whole shake cooler and taste great. Banana, protein, some green powder from MyProtein. These are basically vegetable powders that have in like seaweeds and like superfoods, stuff like that. And, you know, broccolis and all kinds of healthy stuff like that, you know, because I'd like to eat more vegetables, but since I can, it's not practical at the moment for me. I supplement my diet with a little bit of that. The protein, as I said, to kick my protein numbers up a notch, and I combine that with a handful of mixed nuts. I don't need like roasted nuts or fried nuts, stuff like that, like really just simple dry nuts. They're also more fulfilling this way and they have less calories. Moving on, so I have this around 10 o'clock in the morning. Around 1 o'clock I'll have my second meal of the day. This is going to be like the biggest meal of this list. It's usually, I have two choices here. Number one is 3 eggs with 100 grams of cottage cheese and 2 slices of whole wheat bread. Or I'll have 4 eggs, 4 stripes of bacon, and 2 slices of bread. I choose between these two. I usually, you know, 3 days a week I'll have one choice, 3 days a week I'll have the other choice, just to keep things a little bit more interesting. The third meal of the day will be usually 200 grams of Skyr Icelandic yogurt. This is the yogurt I mentioned before with a really high protein and no fat. I combine that with some honey, and, you know, tastes pretty good, keeps you pretty satisfied. I have 3 alternatives here, so I'm gonna either have the yogurt or a peanut butter sandwich, which is like the less nutritious choice out of these three, but, you know, sometimes just for variability I'll have that, or I'll have some oatmeal with 1/2 scoop of protein, because I like how it tastes when you cook it, when you cook oatmeal with protein, and some almond milk. I've been trying this lately because a lot of you have been recommending it instead of regular milk, and tastes pretty awesome, I must say. Has less calories, also less protein, which is like a little bit of a downside, but, you know, you shouldn't be aiming on getting your protein from 100 grams of milk anyways. And my fourth choice of the day is a Milka hazelnut chocolate, basically a hazelnut chocolate, 100 grams. This way, you know, I make sure I get enough of calories, I get enough protein. This chocolate also has 7.5 grams of protein, which is pretty decent. Or I'll have some cereal. So 2 choices again here for my small meal, light meal of the day. Now, before we move on to our third list, the shopping list, we want to make sure that the previous 2 lists provide us enough of nutrition in terms of what I like to call EPM. That's enough energy, calories. So if you want to gain weight, make sure you're on a slight caloric surplus. If you want to lose weight, make sure you are on a slight caloric deficit. If you, protein wise, you want to be getting enough of protein. How much is that? Well, you should be getting at least, I would say, 1 gram per pound, or, you know, that's like 2 grams per kilo. This structure that I use usually gives me around 170 grams of protein per day, which is pretty good for my weight. I'm 160 pounds. And you also want to be getting enough of micronutrients. You know, that means you should be eating enough of the healthy stuff, the fruits and especially vegetables. So if we have a look at this of an example of my daily eating plan, as you can see, 45% comes from carbs, 31%, sometimes that's a little bit higher, 35 comes from fat. I do really well with eating a lot of fat in my diet. Make sure you're not below 20% of fat, because you know that messes up a little bit with your hormone regulation and in general is not that healthy. And you know, I'm getting a decent amount of protein, as we said. So these are the things you want to make sure that you're getting enough of. And how do you do this? Well, what you can do is use this app, My Fat Secret, and just make sure that you know you count one of these, one of your daily eating structures of your daily eating plans, and make sure that you're getting enough of the EPM that we said. On average, you know, if it's a little bit higher, a little bit lower some days, it doesn't matter. But if you just calculate this once when you're setting up this diet plan, you know, after that you don't have to keep you don't have to care about counting calories again and counting protein grams, you know, because you'll be really, you know, consistent with this way of eating. You will be getting enough of all of those. And you know, if you see that you're gaining a little bit more weight that you would like to, just go a little bit lower with your carbs. If you're not gaining enough weight, you know, increase your general calories. If you feel too hungry, you can increase your protein. These are little adjustments you can make. And you know, I know that counting calories and figuring out all your protein intake and all that is really boring, but you just have to do it once. You know, it's just gonna be a little bit of a hassle the first week, and after that you just have to follow your weekly lists, and you know, you don't have to worry about anything else. So let's move on to our shopping list is basically structured in the following way. What you'll do is you'll take your first list, the weekly main meal list, and you'll write next of each meal all the ingredients required for that meal. You'll do the same thing with your daily snacks and lighter meals, and you know, next to each meal you'll write down all the ingredients required again. Now you're going to take all these ingredients and you're going to add them in your shopping list. This is going to be your weekly shopping list. You know, you can always make sure you note down other things that you might need, but as long as you have these, you don't have to stress, you know, like stressing at the last minute if you have the appropriate ingredients to cook your meal is, you know, always ends up messing up your diet. So what I do, usually I prefer paper, but when it comes to your weekly shopping, it's handy to have something as a phone app that you can have at all time with you. And you know, this way you don't have to carry like a paper in the supermarket and like a pen, and you have to hold the pen and the paper and the shopping list. What I use is Google Keep. This is a pretty cool app. It's free. I have it on my Android phone, and this is how it looks. So basically you can add a whole bunch of items. You can know, you can use the subject that you want. I've added here weekly shopping list, and what you can add later is the how are these called? You can add list items. So when you add these thingies here, this list items, and you write next to each item all the ingredients you need, you can walk around the supermarket with this, and you know, everything that you put in your basket, you can just click on it, boop, with your thumb, and it goes down the list. It gets erased. So you know, this way, everything you put in your bag, you can just click on it, and it goes away. So in the end, once you're clear, once you have everything in your basket and everything erased from your list, you'll be sure that you know you got everything. And you know, once you're done, you can just click here, click untick all items, and you know, you have all your items again. You can back this up to your Google account. You can add people to it, so you know, other people, like maybe your girlfriend, you live with your girlfriend, you can She can have the list as well, and you can add items and she can see them on time. You can sync it online, you can back it up, you can do a whole bunch of things. You can add different colors, send them through, I don't know, through apps. So like maybe, let's see here, I guess, yeah, you can send them to a WhatsApp message, to basically anyway, a really cool app. I recently figured this out and I really like it. So that was all for today. Leave me some comments below, your tips, what do you do to, you know, cook more efficiently, to shop more efficiently, to maintain a healthy lifestyle. And until next time, keep on training.